Hey, what up? It's Tampa Brad, and I'm doing an impromptu video, prompted by Apollo actually, on the topic of social media addiction. So we just got done shooting a vid about proactivity and how to be proactive versus reactive, and what the implications are for your life, for your productivity. There's a great book called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People that covers the different things that a person should do in order to be effective and squeeze the juice out of life. And the first habit is to be proactive. When we talked about what happens when you're proactive versus what happens when you're reactive. So I'd highly recommend going and watching that vid. But in this one, I want to really dig into social media, what it's doing to our brains and what it's doing to your brain if you're not consciously thinking about it and being careful in what you're allowing to come into your awareness. So there's a couple things to think about. The first thing to think about is that social media inherently is a business. Facebook is a business. Instagram is a business owned by Facebook. YouTube is a business owned by Google. And these businesses are in the market for keeping people's attention. So what they're incentivized to do is to do the thing that makes them the most money. The thing that makes them the most money is having people spend as much time as humanly possible on their platforms. The statistics on how much time people spend on social media platforms drives advertising spending. If a social media platform can say, hey, the average person that downloads the app then spends 2 hours inside this application, that is a very valuable place for advertisers to place ads.
A study just came out that said that our data is now worth more than oil.
And again, it's important to realize that these apps, yes, they are free, but they are also a business. Something that provides as much value and as much data storage as Instagram or Facebook or YouTube cannot simply exist without there being a business backend. It's what a lot of people tend to forget. They think that because YouTube is just free and it's out there for anyone and it seems to be open sourced, that there's no rules and that it's just a free platform and that everyone has rights to it. But no, that's not how it is at all. YouTube can do A, whatever they want in terms of allowing or disallowing content, which again, separate conversation. But they can also do whatever they want as far as changing the platform and making it more enjoyable for the end user. That can deal with limiting your content, that can deal with changing it so that you feel better when somebody responds to your video positively. That's why there's a like button and a dislike button, and that's why, I mean, getting deeper into it, when people start getting bored, they start layering features to get more in your face and get more screen time. Like, there used to be just a subscribe bar, but now there's a notification bell next to the subscribe bar. The notification bell is there because when a platform gets developed and people get really focused on that platform, eventually it gets diluted over time. So, getting off of the business topic, talking about how social media actually affects your brain. So, there is a tendency in human beings to want to, like Tony Robbins says, go towards pleasure, go away from pain. So the easiest way for social media platforms to get people to stay on them and spend more time there is to give them 99% pleasure, 1% pain. And if it's pain to get off of the platform or to leave it, people are much less likely to do so. Let me ask you a question. Have you tried deleting your Facebook? Seriously, like, this is a serious question. Go in and just, you don't have to actually do it, but attempt to delete your Facebook and see what the ramifications of deleting your Facebook are. They're kind of mind blowing. If you think about how tied in Facebook is to all of your other apps, everything, in some instances, even payments are tied up in Facebook. It's really quite embedded in our society. And I'm not saying this is a bad thing. It's just something that we have to be conscious of. Now let's talk about the real killer here, and not killer, but the real hot button issue, likes. Oh my God. If you want to talk about getting people addicted to something, giving them a numeric value of how much their friends and family like what they did or what they posted. I mean, you literally cannot get any more. You can't get any more extreme in getting someone to pay attention to something is telling them, A, I like this, or B, I do not like this. And the reason why is it actually becomes a game. So what Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook have done is they've made social media and your time spent there into a game. It's literally a, if you see, for example, when you pop up and open your phone, and I'll do it right now, so we'll do this real time. So you open Instagram, right? The first thing that happens is the screen comes up and you get a little red notification down in the bottom. Now it's red because that obviously gets your attention, but then it has a little number next to it. And it's fun to, when you open the app, it makes opening the app fun. It makes it when you get that little hit of, oh, a like, or oh, a follower. Like it's a, oh, oh. It's a push react, it's a push to get a reaction out of you. And again, it's important to not think that this is a bad thing. It's just human psychology. When humans get hit with a little bit of a validation hit, or a dopamine spike is what this might be called, it literally sends off a signal in your brain that says, hey, a good thing just happened. I have permission to feel good. But the flip side of it is, let's say you're a person who typically when you open your phone, you're really popular on Instagram. You typically have, when you open your phone, even if you close it for 2 minutes, you got 99 new likes, 99 new followers, you're maxed out. Most of these notifications won't show you past 99. But what happens if you fall below 99? Like let's say, you know, you go an hour, maybe your last piece of content didn't do very well and you only get 73 likes. Then you're like, oh, hey, I only got 73 likes. I don't feel as good as when my likes are maxed out. I need to do something about this. I need to feel good. Because again, we go towards pleasure and we avoid pain. So if it brought us pain, then we start taking action to rectify that pain. The human brain is like a thermostat. It will not allow you to go below a certain threshold of temperature, thinking of temperature as how good you feel. It won't let you go below a certain level, but it also won't let you go above a certain level. That's a different thing to talk about. But your brain will then prompt you to take action to get back to feeling good. Now, this is very dangerous because if you rely on external sources to feel good, it means that you have zero proactivity. That's why we got into this topic in the last video about the 7 habits of highly effective people and being proactive, is social media inherently gets you in reaction to the environment. It gets you to react to what other people think of you. And in any sphere of life, if you talk to any successful person, they had to, in order to reach that level of success, they had to stop caring what other people thought about them, fundamentally. And the reason why is, if you just do what other people want you to do, you, by definition, can't serve your life's purpose. You can't be doing the important work that you were put on this earth to do if you're living someone else's agenda. You as a human being were not put on this earth to be a battery in the fucking matrix. You're here to live out some insane, extremely important, in your own way, purpose. You're here to walk your own path in life. If you let someone else pull you onto their path and you're not proactively saying, okay, I'm gonna walk on this path for a little bit, but then I'm going to consciously take myself off that path, frankly, you're fucked. You are not going to be happy with your life, because humans who are the happiest are the people who are walking their own path. Now, I wanna wrap this up and put a bow on it, because I don't wanna ramble too much here. But the way out of this, that's the implied question here, is okay, what do we do about this? What's the way out? I strongly believe that there are a couple things that you can do, just simple little tweaks, in order to help yourself with this. One, turn off your fucking push notifications. Do not get notified when you get a fucking like on Instagram. That is a recipe for disaster. It's a recipe for you to be constantly looking at your phone, whipping it out and thinking of whipping it out, not like that. Whipping your phone out and being like, oh, someone else likes me. Someone likes me, oh my God. That is, like I said, a recipe for living in reactivity, not proactivity. Baseline for effective people, if you remember the 7 habits. The second thing, batch your social media use. Only use social media when it's going to be a tool for you, not when you're feeling bad. If you walk into, say, a bar or club, and you immediately pull your phone out and get on Instagram because you feel social anxiety and you want to feel good and you want to feel accepted, that is an indicator of an underlying issue. You got to dive into that issue. You can't just blow it off and be like, oh, well, I'll just depend on my phone for validation and make me feel good. That's not a formula that you're going to be able to follow for the rest of your life. Now, the last thing that I would highly, highly recommend, and I know no one's going to do this, you're not going to do this, but what I would recommend is develop a mindfulness practice. I put out a huge 24-minute video on meditation, the benefits of meditation. If you're a man, there's some great content in that video. You can find it on my YouTube page, or maybe we'll link it up if we figure out how to do that, I don't know. But meditating or having a mindfulness practice, what it does is it gets you present to the moment. It gets you not worrying. It gets that, it calls out that underlying anxiety and the refrigerator hum of thoughts and thinking that's going on, and it makes you aware of it. It will help you to become aware of whether you're pulling out your phone and looking at Instagram in order to make yourself feel better, or are you doing it from a proactive place because you want to share with people. Something to understand is that I love social media, but I love social media as a tool. I love social media as a tool to help me live the life I want to live. I love social media as a tool to put me in touch with the people I want to be in touch with. It helps me to portray a life that I want other people to see me living. Now, you can choose to be mad about that, or you can embrace it and you can go with the flow, take certain measures to not allow yourself to get sucked in and have your brain be addicted to the validation, but you can certainly use it as a tool. And that's what I would highly recommend for you. It's a way for you to live the life that you are meant to live. And frankly, this is just something you gotta handle because it's not slowing down. If anything, it's just speeding up. TikTok is the next evolution of social media. That's a whole nother thing. It's crazy. The last thing I wanna say about this is the ability to focus. Social media, because again, it's made to keep our attention and keep our attention locked in. The thing that human beings love more than anything else in the world is variety. They actually love it more than validation. People love variety more than validation. The social media apps that are becoming prevalent, with stories getting shorter, videos getting shorter, we're getting more and more addicted on validation, and what's going to wind up happening, it's already happening, our ability to focus is being diminished. If you're the type of person who wants to make a ton of money, if you're the type of person who wants to have a real impact on the world, if you want to be part of the Illuminati, the 0.01%, develop your ability to focus. Develop your ability to go out in public and speak your mind, even when there's police around and there's sirens going off and people are riding bikes and shit and scooters are everywhere. Develop the ability to lock in and not worry about anything else that's going on around you. If you can develop that skill, and it is a skill, it's not an inborn trait. No one's born with the ability to do it. You have to develop it by training. It's like a muscle. Do that, because that will be, you know how people talk about the most valuable career? The most valuable skill to have in 2020 on is going to be the ability to focus and do deep work. So that is what I want for you. I want you to be able to focus. I don't want you to be addicted to social media, unless it's my social media, just kidding. So develop that. There's some great books on this, like Focus, The Shallows, What the Internet is Doing to Our Brain. There's a bunch of books on that. We'll go into that in other videos. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Hey, I'm on social media too. Need the subs. If you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button below. Hit the bell next to it so that you get notified when I'm dropping a new video. Follow me on Instagram if you're addicted to it. Follow me, get addicted to my content. It's at Tampa Brad. You know, I'll show you lots of variety there. You can engage with me there all the time. But no, seriously, on a serious note, that's where I engage with people. I respond to all my comments, all my DMs. So hit me up there if you have any feedback. I love feedback. Constructive, destructive, whatever. Let me know what you think. I look forward to hearing from you on Instagram. Thanks again for watching. I really appreciate it. I'm loving doing these vids. Thank you to Apollo for shooting these fucking vids. He's a man. He can do freelance video for you unless you want to hire Home Love Media. Anyways, getting off topic here. Thank you for watching. Peace.